Hello and welcome back. Today we're reacting to some more Kurzgesagt. Today we're going to react to the highly requested what dinosaurs actually looked like. Now, I do have a little bit of pre-knowledge coming into this, I believe. I think that I've heard somewhere before that dinosaurs looked a lot more like modern-day birds than modern-day lizards. Maybe kind of a bit of a fusion of the two, but leaning more towards the birds, that they likely had feathers and were colorful, not the gray, brown, green that was kind of portrayed in classic media and literature. So, I don't know. I don't know if that's true, but I'm pretty sure I've heard that somewhere. So let's dive right in and find out what we don't know.
The past is a vast and mysterious land that begins at the Big Bang and ends in the present.
Hey, we're buzzing already. Now, one thing I just want to point out, and we've talked about in other videos, but might be relevant while we're kind of talking about from the Big Bang all the way to here, is dinosaurs were around for like tens of millions of years, compared to modern day humans have only been around for 200,000 years-ish. So just keep that in the back of your mind when we're talking about dinosaurs and dinosaur evolution.
Expanding with each passing moment. It's the home of everything that came before, the key to understanding our present. Here, we find the most amazing creatures to ever roam our planet. Hundreds of millions of species so diverse that our imagination cannot do them justice. Unfortunately, the past carefully guards its secrets.
That's true.
While there are a lot of things about the past we know, there are way more things we know we don't know. And worse, there are probably even more things we don't even know that we don't know about.
Yeah. Dun, dun, dun. Kurzgesagt.
Think of the wonder of life. We now recognize about 1.5 million eukaryotic species, but there may be as many as 10 million alive today.
What?
And although we are adding some 15,000 new species to our collective knowledge each year, the vast majority of life on Earth is still undiscovered.
I had no idea it was that big of a number.
Around today. An estimated 4 billion species emerged on our planet in past eons. But at least 99% of them died out way before humans spoke the first words. The vast majority of all the different species that ever existed are so utterly deleted that they have become part of the unknown unknown part of the past.
We'll never know about them,
lost
probably.
To us forever. Or are they? Could we use science and imagination to glimpse a shadow of the unreachable past? Let's start with what we do know.
Yeah, okay, let's go.
To learn creatures of the past, we need fossils. Any sort of remains preserved from past geological ages.
With fossils, the thing that absolutely amazes me is that, imagine, if you will, the circumstances required to create a fossil and how rare that occurrence must be. So the fact that we found so many fossils and that it's so hard to actually get them to form and they only form under certain circumstances. Just think of the implications of that.
Bones or shells, impressions or imprints, things preserved in amber. The totality of all fossils on Earth is called the fossil record, and it's the most important window on the past we'll ever have. For a dead animal to fossilize, a number of things must go just right. The right environment, timing, and conditions. And then the fossil needs to survive for millions or hundreds of millions of years and then get back to the surface and then be discovered before natural processes dissolve it.
Yeah, so how many fossils are out there that we just haven't randomly discovered by chance? You know, there's got to be a ton more. If we've only found as many as we found, that's probably a small fraction of how many actually exist, because these are pretty random, right? Discovering them. I mean, we find grounds of them where we know, okay, we found a few here, and we know that this was a pretty common area. We can look here more. But how many more of those areas exist outside that we just have no idea about? Or how many are just too far below our feet that will rise to the surface eventually?
So it is kind of a miracle that we have what we have and know what we know.
You get what you get, and you don't throw a fit.
They were one of the largest and most successful groups of animals for some 165 million years, and are also a lot of fun to animate. What were they really like, and what are we missing?
At least they're honest.
In the last 200 years, we've found tens of thousands of fossils from over 1,000 dinosaur species. Mm-hmm. Lately, we've entered a golden era of discovery, and about 50 new dinosaur species are discovered each year, expanding what we know and what we know that we don't know about them, which is amazing. But it also makes us aware of all the things lost to the past forever. Imagine if we took all the animals that lived in the last 50 million years and randomly chose 10,000 individuals from 1,000 species to fossilize. Hmm? Think about all the things that would be missed or that seem too weird to be true.
Yeah,
like
that's
the giraffe,
very true.
A yellow animal with brown patterns that looks like a horse and an antelope had a baby with a long neck and two tiny hairy horns.
Giraffes are weird,
How many
to be
dinosaur
fair.
Giraffes were there? Animals so weird and selected for ecological niches so specific that evolution molded their bodies very absurdly. Mm-hmm. Today, they might seem made up to us. We know a lot of species are lost forever just because of the environment.
Is that a dodo?
For example, lush jungles basically prevent fossilization, as the chances that an animal will be buried here are low. Mm-hmm. Countless scavengers of all sizes break down freshly deceased animals extremely quickly, and the soil is often so acidic that bones are dissolved.
Yeah.
And so fossils of dinosaurs from jungles are practically non-existent. Today, half of known species live in the few remaining rainforests that only cover 2% of Earth's landmass.
The rainforests that we're destroying at insane paces, humanity just blows my mind. We are so amazing and so smart and have such potential, but we are also so stupid and so reckless. It's just,
Millions of years ago, when dinosaurs roamed Earth, jungles covered much more of the planet. So...
Oh, wait, what did that bird say?
Dinosaurs roamed Earth, jungles covered much more.
It's hard to say how much of the planet was exactly covered with rainforest, so this is only a rough representation. Yeah, well, that makes sense, though, right? That there would have been a lot more jungle back then.
The planet. So, besides some insects and other small animals trapped in amber, there should be millions of species that emerged and vanished without leaving any trace. Trapped deep inside the unknown. But just in general, biology trips us up. Look at your body. It's mainly squishy, gooey, soft stuff.
My body's
which
weird.
Does not preserve well. What remains the longest are the crystallized parts of your bones, and so most dinosaur fossils are bones or teeth, usually mm-hmm. fragments, not entire skeletons.
There's a couple of them where there's been more than just the bones, right? Where we've actually seen sort of mummified remains. And there was one of those of an ankylosaurus. If you ever have the chance, go ahead and look that up on Google, because just seeing that, it's just so, I don't know, it's like a time machine. It kind of takes you back in time. And it's just amazing. And I think that everyone should see that. I would love the chance to see that or something similar to that in real life, like in a museum or something. I've only ever seen pictures online. But, I mean, it's crazy. It's like dinosaur jerky, basically.
This means that almost all boneless or shellless animals are practically wiped from the fossil record. Mm-hmm. If we take a look at the stunning diversity of weird animals like worms, jellyfish, and slugs alive today, we can only speculate what we are missing.
Yeah.
Although, thankfully, many mostly soft and gooey species also left us an incredible diversity of shells that tell us an amazing amount about our past, so at least we have that. Mm-hmm. Still, when we think about all the boneless species that may have existed in the last half billion years, even our best attempt at imagining them falls short. But it's not like reimagining something based on its bones is straightforward, and so the way we envisage what dinosaurs actually looked like has changed a lot in the last few years. In the past, many illustrations had a bony, minimalistic look with a toothy grin to signify fierceness and danger. But if we draw today's animals in a similar way, based on their skeletons, just for the fun of it, we get the most bizarre creatures. Elephants, swans,
imagination's
and baboons
fun.
That look like monsters right out of nightmares.
That's actually a really good thought, is to kind of do the same thing with creatures that we know from the modern world and just see how different an artist's rendition is of that compared to what's actually there. I mean, look at this. This is a great illustration of that, for sure.
So, similar to animals today, we should imagine dinosaurs with much more soft tissue, fat bellies or chests, weird soft parts like skin flaps, lips and gums, and just more pronounced features that would make them seem like much more pleasant fellows.
Yeah, that's really... I love, especially that transition that they just did, seems to really illustrate, like, you're still working with the same bones, but those are all imaginable outcomes, right? So... we have no idea what the dinosaurs looked like.
Some soft features actually leave distinctive traces on bones that we can look for in the skeletons of extinct animals, which is where today's animals with similar features are really helpful. Ah. It's a similar story with colors. Because we know what the feathers of living birds look like, modern technology combined with the exceedingly rare fossils with preserved remains of fuzzy feathers give us a glimpse of the real colors of extinct dinosaurs. We know that tiny Sinosauropteryx had a striped tail, and its tiny dino buddy Anchiornis huxley was white and black with gorgeous red feathers around its head.
But how do we know that? That's the part I don't understand. What trace could that leave in your bones?
Still, for the vast majority of really any ancient extinct species, we have no real clue what color they were. But we know what modern dinosaurs, birds, look like, and here we find the most amazing variety. So some dinosaurs will have tried to blend into the background, while others might have fielded aggressive color schemes to attract mates or to appear dangerous.
Yep.
Some might have had impressive decorations or colorful beaks. Some may have been striped or patterned. Similarly, we don't know that much about dinosaur behavior, although once again we can draw conclusions from existing animals. For example, even apex predators like lions spend a lot of their time lying around and cuddling and licking each other and playing.
Are you lying around? I'm mad at myself for that one.
Why would dinosaurs be so different? When we first found the skull of T-Rex with its mighty teeth and probably the strongest bite of any land animal ever, we imagined a fierce and stupid beast. But modern scanning technology has revealed that T-Rex had a larger brain-to-body ratio than some earlier giant meat-eaters. Huh. And it probably had very sharp hearing, vision, and a sense of smell, and was in all likelihood not a stupid animal. Mm-hmm. So maybe T-Rex was a cuddly fellow that spent a lot of time playing around or impressing potential mates when it was not hungry. Likewise, while their horns and shields might have made ceratopsids appear to be natural-born fighters, they were probably much more than that. Based on the behavior of modern animals and the complex dances some have to go through to mate, maybe their shields were amazingly colorful. Maybe it danced for its mates like many birds do today. Mm-hmm. How intensely amazing these creatures must have been. And what a loss it is to us that we don't get to experience them firsthand. What an even greater loss that there is so much we will never know about them, and even more tragic, all the absurd and beautiful beings that disappeared without a trace.
Well, what's more tragic than that is what we're doing right now, causing many, many, many species, I think there's species daily going into extinction. So, you know, it's sad that there's a huge chunk of the past that we will never know, and it's sad that there's a huge chunk of the past that we'll never fully understand. But it's even sadder that there's so many amazing things today that we haven't discovered that we're killing off, and we know we're doing it, and we don't care. I mean, some people do, but as a species, we don't care.
But such is life.
That's sad.
Time marches on without any concern for our feelings, and the past expands with every moment that passes. Most wild animals alive today will in all likelihood not leave fossils behind and also just disappear forever.
Mm-hmm.
We can do something about that, though. Instead of accelerating the extinction we are witnessing, we could become the guardians of life and preserve it where we find it.
That would be cool.
If possible, in the wild, if not, then in museums, movies, and in our minds.
What do y'all think about like a Jurassic Park type of thing, actually trying to bring dinosaurs back to life using DNA. We know that theoretically you could splice DNA. It wouldn't be 100% accurate, but we could make it mostly or at least partially dinosaur DNA with some modern creatures. I know that the mammoth, the woolly mammoth, was one of the ones that has been talked about quite a bit about doing that with modern elephants. And yeah, it's quite interesting. I personally think that it's something we should do. I think that movies like Jurassic Park and stuff scare us. But I also don't think that something like that's likely to happen. We're a lot more careful these days, and doing that would be dang expensive. And investors want to protect their cash because cash reigns supreme.
Because as amazing as our imagination is, and as fascinating to think about the animals that are part of the unknown unknown, it is even better to witness them in the present.
Thank you.
The land
Thank
that
you.
We actually
yes.
inhabit, where we mm-hmm. get to experience life as it happens.
Yes.
There is one more exciting way to experience dinosaurs, though, this year.
I gotta pick up one of their calendars. But I wonder what future, like way, way, way future, like think after humans are gone, there will likely be more intelligent life down the road, long past when we're gone, which maybe we make it very long. Maybe we make it very far. Maybe we overcome our petty differences as a species and actually cooperate on a huge scale and leave the planet and become a very, very long lasting species. Maybe that's the case. Maybe we last for more than 165 million years. Maybe we don't. But I'm very curious in the future what whatever future intelligence there is will look back on humans. Will we be just a layer in the fossil record filled with radiation? Or, you know, what will we be? When they look back at us, what will they think? That's quite interesting to think about. Anyway, love this video. They do a great job as always. And I love the animations and the transitions in this one. It was very, very eye-opening and informing, especially the part about doing the animations and the pictures of today's animals, of their bone structure, and seeing what we can come up with that. So it kind of opens your eyes as to we have no idea what dinosaurs looked like. If we can't even predict modern animals accurately or even close to accurate. But yeah, anyway, thank you so much. If you made it all the way to the end, please drop me a subscribe. I really appreciate it. It helps me out a lot. Thank you so much. And I hope you have a wonderful day.